To Miguel Tinker Salas, a professor of Latin American studies at Pomona College, and he joins us now from Los Angeles. Great to have you with us, Miguel. Is this Venezuela's Arab Spring?
I don't think so. I think that what we have is on the part of the United States, an effort to dictate the internal affairs of a country such as Venezuela. It's a rupture and a disconnect with the sovereignty of a country. The same thing goes for the Organization of American States, and the same thing goes for Brazil, Colombia, Ecuador, and Argentina. This is a matter for Venezuelans to decide. There is tremendous polarization in Venezuela. There has been polarization since Hugo Chavez was elected in 1998. But to have the U.S. decide who is the president of Venezuela harkens back to the latter decades of the 19th century and to big stick diplomacy, and reminds many in Latin America of empire, because what it does is confirms everything Maduro has been saying, and that is that the U.S. seeks regime change in Venezuela.
But it seems, if I'm correct, and what we're seeing on the ground is that Venezuelans don't seem to support Maduro either. Is that incorrect?
Well, there were dueling marches today in Venezuela. There were dueling marches in Caracas. Most of the media was focused on the opposition marches and not on those who support the government. Again, I underscore, there's tremendous polarization in Venezuela. But the larger question here is that it's Venezuelans who must decide the result of this process, not foreign powers. If we set a precedent that any country that the U.S. decides to target for regime change, the U.S. and its conservative allies get to decide who is the next president. It sets a tremendous precedent, not just for Venezuela, but for countries in Latin America, Africa, Asia, and elsewhere. And that's the larger issue here. There is, again, a long litany of problems in the country, economic, social, shortages, mismanagement. Again, but it must be Venezuelans who decide that outcome and not the mandates coming from Washington.
You make a really great point, Miguel. So what does the U.S. have to gain from regime change in Venezuela? What do they have to gain by backing the opposition leader Juan Guaido?
Well, last October, John Bolton, National Security Advisor, stated that the U.S. would seek to unseat what he called the Troika of Tyranny. And that is that the U.S. would now seek to unseat the Cuban president, the Nicaraguan president, and the Venezuelan president, and that they would all be targeted for regime change. So this is an announced event. People have been expecting this, and the vehicle which was decided upon was the selection of Juan Guaido as the president of the country. He is, in fact, the president of the National Assembly. He was from the state of Vargas. He has not been elected president by the Venezuelans. So in that sense, he doesn't have the legitimacy of having gone through a national election and having been named president by the people of Venezuela. So there is an effort.
I get your point. I get your point, Miguel. But what does the U.S. have to gain from all of this?
It seeks to affect regime change. It seeks to polarize conditions in the region. It seeks to polarize conditions in Venezuela. It knows Maduro cannot allow another president to exist in the country. So it forces his hand. He must now move against Guaido and either arrest him or take other actions. No sitting president would allow another president to exist in the same country. You can't have a country with two presidents. And that's the contradiction that they seek to actually exacerbate.
All right, Miguel Tinker Salas, great to have you on. Appreciate you being with us.